Hi guys, nice to see you back. I'm happy that you like my last topic, and that's why I want to give you some bonus information about that. You already know that sauerkraut juice is rich on this funny word, goitrogenes, or whatever is the word for it. And I want to tell you it's rich also on all of those like magnesium, selenium, iodine, and many others. And my research which I made found an article which says that it's looked over 90 years of period and more than 300 studies and 500 articles, and all of those are making a conclusion that sauerkraut juice is the only one from vegetable origin which contains, and it's rich of a huge amount of vitamin B12. And that's crazy, because we already know that all vegetarians, vegan, and people with gastric surgeries, they have problem with this vitamin. So here are some bonus amazing information just for you. In my previous video, you already know that I was worried to drink sauerkraut juice because of my thyroid issues. So I did my research, and I still wasn't sure if I want to drink it or no. So I connected to one of the guys who wrote a book about the protocol which is for curing cancer and preventing it. So now I'm gonna read you my email to him. Cabbage is high in goitrogenes, which is a problem for people with thyroid issues. So my question is, does the fermentation of the cabbage helps the process of destroying them, like cooking? Do you have any overviews of the subject? Thank you in advance. So here is his answer. Yes, for sure, fermentation of cabbage does not destroy goitrogenes, but small amount and a quarter of a glass of sauerkraut can be consumed for the sake of wonderful probiotic benefits. The benefits outweigh the risk. The amount of cabbage eaten in a typical serving of sauerkraut, a few tablespoons, is not enough to have negative impact on thyroid function. Cabbage and sauerkraut in particular are also high in other nutrients like vitamin C, K, iron, fiber, and in addition, cabbage's cancer-fighting properties are a boon of those of us with Hashimoto's. Along with all the researches which I did, and this answer, it was last proof for me and reason to make sure that I really need to start drinking sauerkraut juice. And I did this during my fighting with cancer, during my chemotherapies. So I'm sure that I have to keep doing this for life and try to prevent of coming back again. And if you're interested to know more of sauerkraut juice, you can watch my last video if you haven't, and the link is below. Now I have a surprise for you, just because I'm sure you are guessing that we're gonna cook, right? So here we go! Thank you. finished with cooking and I'm back to you. And as you see, I like simple recipes. This was just 3 easy steps: prep, boil and blend. That's it. And you could see they're as healthy as possible. There is no fats, no milk, no cream, no butters and anything like that. In my opinion, they're amazing just the way they are. But if you use any of these ingredients and you want to ask some flavor, to add some flavor, you can do it. But I recommend you try this version, and if you wanna add some flavor, do it after that. And if you want me to try and actually make for you some healthy version of a recipe which you like, you can comment below and let me know, or you can contact me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. And we're gonna see you soon. Just make